Hey, Brian, it is so great to speak to you. How are you doing?
Very good. Thank you for the opportunity, Naftali.
Good to see you. My pleasure. My pleasure. And, you know, we've been talking a little bit while, kind of like between ourselves, about Corona and all the challenges that people are facing. And as I've been putting content out there, what I've been asking people who understand the current reality and are looking ahead to the future is, how do we disaster-proof ourselves moving forward? Because we seem to have these disruptions pretty often, unfortunately. Every decade or so, there's something big, hits us on the side, knocks us off kilter. And I think Corona is the biggest one, combining maybe the other two, you know, of 9/11, of the Great Recession. I mean, this is massive. So people are in retreat mode. People are struggling to figure out, how do I survive, let alone move forward? And at the same time, we need to be thinking about the future. So as we talk about disaster-proofing your business, which I think is something you bring a lot of value to, tell me a little bit about your take on what Corona has done for us, some lessons you've learned from it. And eventually, what I'd like to bring us to are some steps that people could be taking to make sure that whatever kind of business they are running, they're in better position moving forward, that even something big comes along and knocks us sideways, they don't get knocked fully off balance. They could operate, and ideally they can even thrive in those circumstances.
No doubt. So again, thank you for the opportunity to share some words today. And I'm going to share some words that aren't just mine also, because I think that sometimes people get a little full of themselves when they cannot acknowledge that there's other wisdom out there in the world. Let's start off with a quote from Mark Twain. It isn't the stuff that you don't know that gets you into trouble, but it's the stuff that you do know that just isn't so. So I think that everybody who thought that they were just sitting pretty and all that, and everything's bulletproof and nothing ever happens to real estate, really? What planet are you on, bro? Didn't you notice the housing market crisis before? There's all these things. And, you know, it's funny, Naftali, I did a video, and we can actually put it in the links later, February of last year. I was explaining to the world, there's no way that the economy can just go up forever.
Right.
We just concluded the largest growth period of American history. We had 129 months of consecutive growth that stopped in March. I already saw fissures in the market, and it didn't make any sense to me. I didn't know what everybody was excited about. Things don't just automatically go up and up and up forever. If
Correct.
You flip a coin, what's the chance that it's going to be heads? So let's say you get 10 heads in a row. Do you really think that you're just guaranteed that it's going to be another heads? So I think this has shown how at risk everybody is. And the sad reality is there was so much stuff that was messed up in the housing market, commercial real estate, stock market, all these different things, specific industries that people just took for granted. And now everybody's just sweeping it under the rug, under the guise of coronavirus. And that's absolute nonsense. So let's just take all this to mean, to understand that we are very much more vulnerable in a lot of areas that we take for granted. And we really should be mindful of those in just regular things like your headcount and all sorts of things that I think we're never gonna hear again. Where are you located? How many square feet is your operation? How many people work there? All of these questions are not as relevant as you might think. I think the questions that people mean to ask are, how good are you at doing what you said you're gonna do for my business, product, service, whatever. So I think it's very important to adopt, now that we're all bored or have more time on our hands, which I don't believe either of those. I think those are delaying the inevitable. I think that we should take this time to recalibrate and set ourselves upon a different kind of mindset. And that is the one where you've heard me talk about this word. And I told you I'd bring up this word. And you're like, who knows what this word is?
Well, here it comes.
Here comes the word. The word is anti-fragility. Before I tell you what anti-fragility is, everybody, let's talk about two other models that you actually do know what they are. Because you haven't heard that word. But you've heard one word that's very close to it, which is fragile. And you've also heard another word that is just absolutely beat to death all over the place, which is resilient. Let's start with resilience. So let's say we're the star of the show, the hero of our favorite video game, whatever. And we start out and we've got all our armor and our suits and whatever you feel like over here. You start with full health, you're at 100%, and then life comes along, just beats you down. And now you get knocked down to 25%. You're almost dead, but you're resilient, right? So what happens? You come back from the 25% to 50% to 75, 80, 90. Maybe you even fully recover. Congratulations, everybody. You are resilient. You bounced back. And everybody's like, that's amazing. What more could you want out of life? Well, we'll get to that. Reset. On to number two. Now let's look at the fragile reality. We start at the same, we're the same character. We start at 100%. Life beats us down, down to 25%. And maybe we never recover and game over and then we're gone, right? We're just knocked out of the box. Those two things are pretty easy to understand. And chances are we've all lived those realities, even pre-coronavirus. And by the way, I don't like when people say Corona or the Rona. It's not your mascot. It's not your buddy. It's a world pandemic to be taken seriously as we weep for the world. All right, so deep breaths. Now, let's imagine if we can, that there's something better than both of those two models. Anti-fragile. We start at 100%. We get knocked down to 25%. And then through all the stuff that we learn along the way, somehow in the inner reserves of our essence, we rise up not just to 100, but to 200, 500, 1,000, or whatever it is.
That sounds much better.
Yeah, isn't that a little better? And I'm not a genius. There's a guy who's an economist who wrote the book about the black swan, about how there's like just this one blip on the overall stock market. And if you miss that day, you've kind of missed the whole point. And it's the same guy who talks about this. So by all means, and we can also link to this in the recording as well, do look up anti-fragility, because I think it is an incredible model to aspire to in times like this, because everything doesn't need to be free and we don't have to just say we're bored and we're in it together and let's have virtual happy hours. No, now is the time to really examine where you're overexposed and what you actually do. Now, if you're a real estate agent, or let's say you're a travel agent, you own a hotel, something that's obviously like really hurting right now, to just cheer you up and say, let's talk about strategies of when things are going to be fine. How are we ever guaranteed another day that everything is going to be fine? We have seen that things are not fine. And I don't have secret information into the future, but I would imagine as everything relaxes, we may see quite a bit more death and dismay, because if we model it after the world's last pandemic, which was the Spanish flu, which started in 1918, the majority of what really did the most harm economically and human life-wise was the second wave. So please, please think about being safe and think about changing the way your business works. We're all noticing that telework works quite well, right? So there's an opportunity here to really reframe what you're doing in a way that can be understood, that can be nimble, and that can move with the market. Listen, this is when you see the some of the largest transfers of wealth in human history. If you go back a few generations, this is when
it's interesting, Brian. I had somebody, if I may cut in for a second, I had somebody on a podcast, Alden Mills, who I love this idea. And we just recorded it the other day. So it's very fresh in my mind. And he talked about the opportunity on the other side of uncertainty.
Yes.
We have a lot of uncertainty right now. We have a lot of challenges, no question about it. But everyone can find opportunity, both in terms of how they bring their market, their service to the market, and at the same time, in evaluating the quality of what they do and using this as an opportunity to reset. So I love the value there. Anything else, I guess you'd say before we wrap up, that people should be doing in a very practical way that's going to help them for the moment and as they think forward?
Final minute. You can transfer the skills that you're already good at into opportunities that you hadn't thought of before. Let's say you're good at sales, but let's say you're good at sales for the travel industry. Not working right now. Nobody's even allowed to go anywhere. So what if you could transfer those sales skills into something that is making money, like e-commerce or the pet industry or the cannabis industry or cybersecurity or online learning or video streaming or different SaaS products? I assure you, there's places that are doing better than ever before. So I would advise all of you to shift the axis of your thinking and apply your skills to things that are working well right now.
Awesome. Thanks, Brian. Appreciate you coming on. Tremendous value. And hopefully we'll get through this together. Even though I shouldn't say that. But you know what I mean.
Sure do. Appreciate you. Thank you.
Bye-bye now.